The demonstration, which is being organized under the social media banner "Open Our Borders Now," and we're joined by thousands of residents in the Volta region, especially residents of the Ketu South municipality. Some of the residents who spoke to City News say the continuous border closure has affected their businesses negatively.
All efforts to the government to allow us for the borders to be open so that those of us residing at the border side can be crossing for economic activities fair. So therefore, we appeal to our parliamentarians, we appeal to stakeholders to help the government listen to us. But still, it's like it's fallen on deaf ears. So today we are organizing one of the mega demonstrations in Ghana in order to send a signal to the government that we need the borders to be open. Just as the airports are also open for goods and services and human beings to be passing through and through, the same thing we want the government to do over here. In the Southwest African regions, other borders are open. It is only Ghana that has seriously closed its borders beyond control.
They are working in the Togo, and they are supposed to open the border for us. We are suffering because of the border. We people are not getting job to do. I'm a messenger. I have job in Togo. When I'm going to crossing, and then people are telling me to give money before crossing.
Sometimes the border has been closed, and it is bringing hardship onto the people in the South, the people of border region, especially the people who live along the borders. It's bringing hardship on us, and there's a need for the president to listen to our cry this morning and open the border for us. Because we, the people around here or along the borders, we largely depend on Togo for our livelihood, for our daily bread. So as the border has been closed, it is becoming very difficult, unbearable. Life has become very difficult for us.
Addressing the gathering after a peaceful demonstration through the principal streets of Denu and Aplau, the protesters have accused the government of discrimination to people living along the borders as people come into the country daily via airports, even when similar COVID measures could be put in place at their borders. In a petition read by the convener, Mr. Brigila, he says the closure of the border has become a burden to the people.
It is now very clear to us that this virus has come to stay. Hence the need for government to strike a balance between containing the virus and maintaining the day-to-day economic activities that millions of Ghanaians living along the border depend on to survive. Currently, the pandemic and its resultant border closures, trade restrictions, and confinement measures have affected the entire domestic food system of the border communities, most especially Aplau, therefore threatening food security. The ripple effect has been a dying local economy, reduced access to health care, and job losses. Now, in line with social and economic development, we have seen broken social and economic ties. All socio-economic activities, including exchanges between border communities, have been eroded drastically. Whilst tensions continue to build, in the face of this, the bond between neighboring communities is gradually going extinct.